It's the 1st of January, 2022, and I haven't uploaded yet a 2021 rewind video. Okay, let's get right into it, I guess. Now, yes, you're hearing this correctly. This is a new microphone. Let me show you, I guess. Yeah. Okay, so this right there is my webcam, the one that you see over there, the one that you were just seeing the video. That's the webcam. Every single video on this channel has been recorded using this microphone, the built-in microphone that, let's be real, it's not the best sounding microphone, but it is good, okay? I've seen way worse microphones. And yesterday, look what came in the mail. Finally, I've got an actual mic. It's USB, it's not jack, and it connects to the cable that came with micro USB and not Type-C. But it's actually really good. The quality is not the best. But hey, I mean, for 50 euros or something, it's great. So if the audio is a bit weird, then please comment down below and I'll make sure to fix it. I still have no idea how to use an external microphone. As you can see, I'm just recording the audio through OBS. I've already recorded the podcast episode and I recorded this through Tenacity, which is basically Audacity, the fork of Audacity. That I've actually contacted one of the developers and all that. So yeah, hello Panos. Yeah, it doesn't have any like knob to control the volume or any button to like mute the microphone, as you can see here. The stand is basically not at all adjustable, but hey, it's a proper microphone for the first time. And that is what's important right now. And let me add a little reminder to actually upload this video to Mega so that I can actually get this later while I'm editing. I'll actually do this right now. Good thing I didn't record 1080p, 4K and I only recorded high definition footage. Yeah, just upload it wherever you can. Okay. We're uploading. But yeah, this year I won't be streaming this live because my internet is shit and I'm really tired and also I'm a bit sick. It's not COVID, don't worry. Yeah, so I can't really talk all that loud, so I will be taking small breaks and I will be coughing and all that, so yeah. And also don't have anything ready. As you saw, my desktop is just OBS running. I don't have any notes or anything. So this would be fun. I will basically go through the channel from January till December of 2021 and talk about stuff that happened. So let me open my web browser and let's get right into it, I guess. This right here is my channel, as you can see. It's still the Christmas decorations and all that, so I will be changing them by the time that you see this video, but right now, since it's the 1st of January, as you can see here, I won't be really doing anything, and let me put this to do not disturb. So let's go to videos and scroll all the way down to the first video that I uploaded of 2021, and that was the Deepin 20.1 Distro Reviews Season 2, Episode 4. It was the fourth episode of Season 2. I'm not sure if it was the last one or not. Let me. Yeah, it probably was. Yeah, it was the last one. So, Season 4. I haven't. Oh my god, I just realized that I haven't done Distro Reviews for a year. Yeah, and I was supposed to upload one today. I just didn't really have the time to record an episode. Okay. So, yeah, that was the first video. And then a whole month passed. And I uploaded the I'll Become Library exclusive, which was one thing that I really wanted to do. It was basically to only upload videos on Library, which now I think is called Odyssey. Yeah, for a couple of months, but as it turned out, I didn't do that at all. I posted one video, which is a really nice video. Let me try to find it if I go to my channel. Good thing that we finally have custom links on both YouTube, as you can see here, youtube.com/c/papasfilms, and on Odyssey, we had one since the beginning, odyssey.com/@papasfilms, which this video is also available there, so you should go and watch it there. Yeah, why not? It's free. And as you can see, my internet is amazing. It won't even load this. Okay, it's starting to load now. It will take some time. So, content, as you can see, we actually have the Christmas decorations here. It won't load, but yeah. And it should be Right at the start of this year, I'm just checking, 1 year ago, so the days of that Velvet checklist, Arch Linux in less than 30 minutes. That was a video that I uploaded a few months before the Arch installer came out, so it's a bit out of date now, but it's using Arch 5. Basically, I'm using Arch 5 to install Arch Linux on a VM in less than 30 minutes. It took me 20 something minutes, plus all the downloads, plus everything. So basically the whole recording was 30 minutes and I cut it down to 20 because I really want this to be kinda in depth. But yeah, as you can see, every single video then after that is just what I've uploaded to YouTube. So that was the only one that was library exclusive. Then obviously the Setup Tour 2021, which I will be uploading one this year. At least some stuff has changed here, new tubes, a new wireless charger, new microphone, new mouse. Yeah, that's about it. 7th of February, by the way. Then, same month, February, I started getting really into making scripts. So I made an automation script to install the BusStop application, which is now outdated. I don't think anyone uses it now. I'm not very sure if you can download it, but yeah, I made the script and I probably still have that. If I remember where I put it, I think it's GitLab. And oh yeah, this reviews. Let me go to my profile here. I haven't logged in, as you can see. Chilling with Fedora 35, so I have been here. Yeah, as you can see, I have it here. Last commit was around February something. February 13th. That was the last commit that I ever did here. A version 1.999. And yeah, I mean, it's not bad. Okay, so I say here that we are currently trying to fix the above issues and ETA is not yet possible to be made. Yeah, I've completely stopped working on this project, so. But yeah, like, yeah. As you can see here, I want to make this for popular scripts, but I didn't. And yeah, that's about it. Let's see what the last commit was. Fix the previous issues of the GNU / Linux version, not on the Tails one, updated readme.markdown, so that was the last one, authored 10 months ago. So you can see that this whole thing happened just 2 days, then I completely stopped working on it. Yeah, also made one through Tails, one commit, 4 additions and 4 deletions, so yeah. Change that only the Tails version. Yeah, I should add like a sleep command there. Maybe I will do it in a live stream if I get bored. I don't know. Then I uploaded what is the best performing video on my channel right now. It is the Hugo Punch system. Yeah, from A Dead of Night, which is still to this day one of my favorite games. I haven't played it, but I was like a bit Ryan, played 5 times. So I love it, and it has 25,000 views, 25,747 views, and 36 comments. And in case you're wondering what this song is, you've already heard this on Papa's Backstage. Yeah. So basically, the only thing I did was to take the trailer of the game, which is included in the press kit that I requested, and then I just looped the music really badly, and then at the end I just put like my outro and stuff. And someone actually watched this video, I can't find it here, but actually made a better version of this. It's still my video, but just with a different soundtrack. So yeah, you should definitely go and check it out. If I find this, I will put it down in the description. If I not, then I don't know. Then I started making some shorts because that was when they came out. So yeah, Tax Talk, the last episode of Tax Talk, which was episode 5, which I only streamed this on YouTube and uploaded just a preview on Spreaker. So with that Spotify, Deezer and all that. The reason being that this was the PowerSchool Show episode 1, where I talk about why, what happened with all these problems. Then, of course, buys once again the BusStop automated installation script on Magia 8, which is a distro that released, and it's a distro that, to this day, I still love. Then I made the video about IP grabbers, which didn't really perform all that well, but hey. A video about Chromebooks. I then actually bought a Chromebook. I have it right there. It's the Chromebook Duet. I'm not sure which version. I think it's the first one, actually, from Lenovo. Now I think we're at generation 5. This is generation 1, I think. Or at least somewhere close there. Love it. Super slow. But hey, for what I needed, it's more than enough. Then Deepin 20.2 live initial thoughts. As you can see, I really, really liked Deepin this year. The most appearances that has had on my channel, probably, in a year. Then we started my favorite, or one of my favorite, because every single series on this channel is basically my favorite, but one of my top favorite series, which is the Course completely original Reddit series. And yeah, as you can see right here, the first one had a recroll, the title right there. So yeah, just definitely go and watch it. I will put it somewhere up here on a card if I remember to do this. Then I made a whole tier list of my favorite editors, because editors, video editors are like one of my favorite subjects and applications to talk about. Then Arch Linux installer, it actually came out. I tried using it on this video, I think. It didn't really work because it was like the first commit. After 2 or 3 days, they ironed out all the bugs and I actually installed Arch on my system. Although, no, wait. Okay, basically the installer came out and then I got the idea of initial week. So I actually prepared for that. As you can see, I have 6 episodes and actually I was supposed to do 7, but I got bored at the end. And with episode 6, I didn't even finish the episode, I just left it there. Then that's just something that me and Felipe from Twitter, no, from YouTube and Twitter and all that, you know him probably, decided to do for fun, and I uploaded here. Bypass YouTube age restrictions without signing, one of my like top performing videos of this year. And I think that was when I decided that, you know what, Fedora and Gnome is amazing, but I should try Arch. So no, I didn't try Arch, actually. I remember that I went to the sea, and then the moment I came back to my house, like at around 2 or 3 p.m., I just installed OpenSUSE Tumbleweed with KDE, and probably all videos till here, the 30 days challenge, were on OpenSUSE, which I loved it, by the way. It's one of my favorite distros, although I had some problems with printing, so I hoped, basically. Else I would have stayed there. And then I tried Arch with the Arch installer and Endeavor and all that, but it was really horrible. I actually decided to go to Arch with KDE Plasma and Endeavor with KDE Plasma. Basically every single distro for like a month or two was KDE Plasma because of this video that I made here. I really want to give Plasma another try. But then at around here, I decided that, you know what, let's just go back to Fedora and Gnome, which is where I am right now. Let's get rid of this. This is where I am right now, and I absolutely love this. I will never hope, at least I hope so, until something better comes out, like the Maui sale or something. Then I recorded another episode of Course. This was the second one, and I think we have 3. Yes, we do have 3 so far. Then obviously the KDE Plasma versus Gnome video that I did, which was a live stream, so I haven't made a thumbnail for it. The KDE Plasma video, which is when I, as I told you earlier, I started trying KDE Plasma again. The Passroom show came out right here. Didn't really do all that well, as you can see here. Yeah. Brave Browser, as you can see right now, I'm using Brave Browser, so this video really got me back into Brave Browser, and I use it basically every single day. As you can see here, yeah, I'm a verified creator now on Brave. Then I made a Q&A that I actually want to make for a really long time, and I, like, the questions were like a year old by the time I made the video. I really enjoyed making it, didn't do all that well, but in case someone has any question that I've answered there, you can go and check it out. Another PowerSchool Show episode. Relax OS, the first version came out, which I said that I really love this, and I remember really liking it, but I don't think they've made any new releases since then, so I'm not checking it out again, probably, unless they make like a really big release. Pop! OS 2104 came out with the Cosmic Desktop, so that deserved a live stream. It was a 1-hour live stream, and checking it out, actually, as you can see here, I streamed this from my Chromebook and captured my desktop and all that. Yeah, it's a bit weird how I do these streams right now, but I really like doing them. And it also deserved a Papa's Film Show episode, so a podcast episode. Another course, which I really like, so yeah, why not? Let's feel some nostalgia. One of the worst videos that I've ever uploaded on this channel. It's basically going back to the old style of my videos, so the gaming channel and all that, didn't perform all that well. Horrible, basically. Don't go and watch it. So I used OpenSUSE template with for 30 days, which was a podcast episode, the Power Slim Show episode 4 bonus episode, the last one on the season. It did kind of well, so great. Is an eBay scam. I basically, why I did this is I bought a Grand Theft Auto 5 Premium Edition from an eBay, and I'm like, hey, people, remember, this is not really a scam. And so, yeah. It didn't do well. It has a lot of comments, mostly negative, so yeah. I started playing Papers, Please. I bought the full game, or not really. I pirated it. I played this right here, the live stream, two live streams. And then a friend gifted it to me through Steam, because it's only like 6 euros or something. Yeah. And then I actually made a whole series, kinda, on my other gaming channel, so yeah. Apple One I Lost is basically a video about how, from the perfect Android ecosystem, I want the perfect Apple ecosystem with the iPhone 11, the Apple Watch SE. Yeah. And that was basically the last video of 2021, because afterwards, I just posted some trailers for Distro Review Season 3, which, yes, it was supposed to come out today, 1st of January, Saturday, but I just didn't really have the time. Nor the microphone, because this one doesn't really work anymore. That's why I got a new microphone, so I couldn't do it. I'm thinking that maybe I will do it this week. If not, then I don't even know anymore. Yeah, then Power Slim Show Season 2, and the first episode that came out 3 weeks ago, which is actually a really nice episode. You should go and check it out. And that's how this year ended for my channel. Now, some milestones was obviously 100 subscribers. 100 YouTube subscribers, which is amazing. When I started this channel back in 2018, I think it was. Let's go ahead and see. It was 12th of January 2018. So this year we're celebrating the 4 years of this channel. Maybe I will tweet something about it, I don't know. I never actually thought that this would happen. I think that maybe like 20 subscribers or 50, when I reached 50 was the cap. And if we actually go to my YouTube studio page, and we actually go to the subscriber count that they recently added, and we change this to lifetime of this channel, you can see really that basically 2018, 12 subscribers, 25, so basically from late September to basically the whole of 2019, this channel really actually started growing. So we went to 52 subscribers. I actually made the post back in 2019. Let's see when exactly. 6th of April 2019, or 5th of April 2019. I was actually out eating, and then I check my YouTube and I see that, okay, we've reached 50 subscribers. So I made an Instagram post saying, yay, or something. Maybe I will find this if I go to Instagram. Let's see. Let's scroll all the way back. As you can see, Teslas came finally to Greece. It was amazing when I heard the news, actually. No, this is for 70 subscribers. Here we go. You can see my old style of like the profile picture and everything, which was probably the worst one that I ever put there. And I'm like, 50 subs, boy. Okay. Yeah, I'm not really glad for this post or anything. That was this picture here is from the last day that I was actually able to go to like theater and actually perform there. Yeah, afterwards COVID hit, so yeah. The Mac project, I'm not gonna talk about that. That's 2020, it's not 2021, but probably the worst video ever. 70 subscribers, you can see. If you go back here, you can see that for a really long time, for basically one whole year, we were stuck at 50 subscribers. Nothing happened. Then what happened is that during 2020, and a bit of 2019, I decided that I'm going Linux full time, stop the gaming, only Linux. And this led to even more subscribers just going away. It's not really well showed here, but I lost some subscribers. I didn't gain any because I was doing Greek Linux videos. And then I changed this to English. So I lost another bunch of subscribers, which for some reason I can't see it here. I remember losing a lot. And then after some time, so basically, yeah, March, we started gaining subscribers of 60, 70. It was 16th of June, so I made a post here. I actually realized this 30 of June 2020. It's official, we have just passed 70 subscribers. Thanks to all of you. And then, thanks guys, that's the caption. Ah, yeah, I also got a Nintendo Switch last year. I forgot about that, if I'm being honest. Merch, which this year I haven't really put out a winter bundle. I'm not sure if I can. I will check this out later and make a tweet about it. I don't know. Just follow me on Twitter, by the way. And then, this year, 2021, the channel skyrocketed, quite literally. As you can see here, we surpassed 100 subscribers, 6th of June 2021. Amazing! I made a whole post about it. I've actually taken a screenshot. And again, the channel was with the normal profile pictures, was with the Pride Month pictures that I have actually made a new version for this new profile picture that I have and branding. Yeah, this was the profile picture right here. And we just gained the subscriber. Thank you. And yeah, then the channel continued to skyrocket. And at the 31st of December, we had 145 subscribers, which I think it's not the highest. I think we went to 147 or something a day. I don't know. Yeah. And yeah, now we have 146 subscribers. So thanks. I never actually imagined about having all that audience. So yeah, thank you guys. It's really a dream come true. And now for the other stuff that happened with this channel. We got a new channel, Faster Than Average Cuber, which is all about cubing, and I've only made two videos here. Don't subscribe to this channel. The guy making it is an idiot. And we obviously have Papa's Backstage, which rebranded, and I uploaded some episodes, as you can see here. Yeah. I stopped this series because I lost the save files and I don't really want to start this all over again, so yeah. Okay, we won't have a winter merch collection this year, but at least we got the winter theme here. So yeah, that's cool. And yeah, I still have the merch here available if you want to get it. I haven't bought one of these. Yeah, it's just there. This one is actually a really cool shirt. I'm not sure how the design came out, but it's really cool with the OG logos and stuff. So that's about it channel-wise. And this video is already 40 minutes. 40. So yeah. The only thing I want to talk about is games. Did I enjoy playing any games this year? And actually, yes. My recommendation for you guys to actually go ahead and buy it right now because of winter sales, Steam winter sales, is Tech Support Error Unknown. And it's basically a game where you work as a tech support specialist on a company. You have to help customers, you have to do your job right, you have to get paid. But there is also a story, which is basically another company or a terrorist group, I don't really remember. I played it a few weeks ago. Contacts you to take down the company that you're working for, but then the company that you're working for says that no, this is true, this is false information, you have to say no and work with us. Then the police contacts you. There is an ending. There are 22 endings. I've got two, ending 1 and 20, the good and the fired ending. There is a, if you do the right decision and all that, the actual developer of the game will contact you because he needs support, and then says, oh, if you don't do your job right, I will make a game just for you. So yeah, that's funny. I also really enjoyed playing Train Simulator. 2022 is the latest edition. They update it every year. I got it for 11 euros, probably like 4 days ago. I've already put it to 6 hours or something. And I really enjoyed 112 Operator. I've only like 2 hours there, but yeah. Any other games that I enjoyed? No. I 100% Super Mario 3D World on a Wii emulator, Wii U emulator. I'm sorry, with Felipe. He was basically here every single day of the year in order to 100% this. I got Mario Party Superstars for the Switch, and that's about all the games that I got this year, I think. And I really enjoyed GTA 5. Movie wise, I don't even know. The only movie that I went to see on the like cinema, the theater, was Matrix Resurrections. Amazing movie. Go and watch it. And or pirate it, I guess. And yeah, that's about everything I had to say for this year in Rewind, basically. I'm sorry that it was a few days late. But yeah, I don't really have anything else to say. I'm sorry for all the audio glitches and difficulties that I may have on this video. But yeah, have a good one. Happy 2022. Peace out.